Hey guys, this is Hawkeye and I am at Missouri's Mudwater River, and I just happen to be here at the Last Songs of Summer. Now the reason I am here and I'm back here again, now I know I've already done the catfish, I've already done the bass, I've done a lot of things that you've seen and kind of seen before, and as updates have come, but the last time I was here and I did the bass fishing, I just caught bass. And I think I had posed the question, are there any trophy bass here? Well, according to my friend Dulakaba, there are, but they're very rare. Now, I must have fished and fished and fished trying to catch these guys with both bait casting and with float fishing. Wasn't getting any, and I tell you what, I caught my first trophy here, and I caught it when I was trying to fish for freshwater drum. I was trying to find out where the locations for the freshwater drum were, and guess what? I found a location and time for the largemouth bass. And it's right here at the Last Songs of Summer. Now, what you have to do is you have to come over here. Now, I tell you, the reason I found out is because I was fishing with shrimps. So apparently, I don't know if that's the key thing or if it was just luck or what the deal was, but it just so happened that I happened to land them. And I think the reason I did is because a lot of times when you're fishing for these guys, it happens to be in the same location as the bowfin, so you end up landing the bowfin. But with the shrimps, I'm not saying you won't land a bowfin, but they're a little less likely. So what we are going to do, guys, is I've got my OmniFloat 14-foot 10-inch, and I've got some 0.008 monofilament line, and we are going to upgrade this to a much larger hook. We're going to go with a 4-aught, and we are going to take this sucker down to about 30 inches. Yeah, that's a good amount. Also a good amount for bowfin. Therein lies the risk. Got my chubby bobber. And it seems like the time for these guys, the best time of all, is around 6 p.m. Now, that's on sunny days, guys. I don't know what about cloudy days. I have not been able to figure out the time for cloudy, and I swear, as soon as I do, guys, I will be putting out another video for the or something, letting you guys know when the best time is for the cloudy. Anyway, let's go ahead and get this set up here. I am going to go ahead and advance time to 6 p.m. And we are going to, I'll show you where they are. They are right out here. Now this is prime bowfin territory, guys, as I have said. So do not be surprised if the bowfin are going to give us a little trouble. Now, I'm going to reel this in just a little bit because it's a little far off to the left of what I want it to be. I wonder if our little friend is out there. Yes, he is. He's still there. Oh, come on, man. Don't tell me you've quit on me already. No, he is not. He has not quit on me. All right. Okay, we got us a good fish here, guys. We have got us another good fish. Alright, let's get this guy in. Okay. gonna put a little more power behind this. Now, I don't know if you had noticed before, I was trying to keep it at about a 45 degree angle, but for some reason on that one, he just somehow was able, I think he was swimming towards me. And sometimes when they do that, it gives them enough time to get some, a little leeway and get off that hook. This guy is not gonna make me get him in easily. He's gonna fight me. And this is this is a bass. There's no doubt in my mind. The way he's fighting, no doubt in my mind. And he is not a little guy. I can't seem to get him much past. Or much. Oh gosh, he's doing what that other one did. I don't know if I can. No, I was gonna try to muscle him there a little bit more, but it's just a little too risky. He'll break this line for sure. All right. He's coming in now. Okay, he's swimming towards me. I'm just gonna keep reeling. Okay, he's gonna fight a little bit now. Keep reeling. Keep it up. Keep that angle up. Darn it. Keep it up. I still have 200 feet, fish, so I'm not giving up yet either. I swear to God, I have never in my life fought one this long and this hard. I mean, I've fought a gar this hard and this long, and he is not giving up. I thought these things were supposed to get tired after a while. Look at that. He is almost at the 300 feet now. Oh no. He's making one more run for it, and my hand is so tired. I cannot believe this. This fish is amazing. Yep, he's making one more run for it. I don't believe this. I cannot. I don't know if I can do this again. Well, maybe he can't. I think he's coming in now, finally. Good God, I have never seen a fish fight like this. There he goes again. This fish does not want to be caught. There he goes. He is, yet again, he is running out 150 feet. Good God Almighty. Holy crap. My hand is killing me. Okay, this might be a little ridiculous. This fish has to be tired by now. Come on, fish. It's like 1:30 and he just gets another bunch of energy and strength. God, there he goes again. Look at that. Back out to 200 feet. He is not. I might not get this fish. I might actually not be able to get this fish. I have to actually be somewhere. I didn't know that this was going to take this long. This fish was going to fight this hard. He's not budging. Not even coming close. Yep, it's too late. I have to quit. Guys, this is Hawkeye and it's another day. Hopefully things will go a little bit better this time. Honestly, I will tell you, I had caught that fish and had to let it go. I fought it for 25 minutes. 25 minutes, guys. No joke. I'm sure I could have gotten it in, but I had to leave. I think I'd said earlier in the video that I was going to have to leave. I was hoping I was going to pull this fish in. And unfortunately, well, my wife came in and said that we had to go. And I had to let him go. That about killed me. Anyway, I am back and it's another day. And we're going to get this trophy bass if it kills us. So what I have decided, instead of using the rod that I was using before, which you can obviously catch them, you just have a fight on your hands. What I decided to do is to go with a much heavier rod, because I want to get this guy in. That's just all there is to it. It's become war now, okay? Anyway, the rod that I'm using at this point is the Phoenix 14 foot by 10 inch. And this is a pretty heavy-duty rod. We're talking 5 to 13-pound test line it can use. I'm using the Hornet Swarm 6000. This is a heavy, massively great reel. Shouldn't have any problem getting this guy in. And I'm also using Fluoroline 0.010. I believe, I'm not sure what the pound test on that is. I believe it's like maybe 11 pounds, maybe 8 pounds, I'm not sure. Anyway, we're going to get this guy in. So we're going to get this back down to about 30 inches here. Oh, come on. Get down there. There we go. Sometimes it's hard to get the mark on that. Got the 4-aught hook, got the chubby bobber. Everything else is the same except I just have a heavier rod. And I'm going to make sure this is at 30 inches. I'm determined, guys. We're going to advance this to 6 p.m. because I didn't want to lose any time. Now, I'm sure there are, like I said before, I'm sure there are probably other times, but this is the time I've been able to get them, and I swear I've been getting a lot of bites. These guys are fighters. Massive fighters. Alright, we got this thing out there, and I'm going to get this guy, I swear to God. This time we're bringing him in. There we go. Alright, let's bring this son of a gun in. Let's bring him in. Ah, oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh, no. No, 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 no. That's not what I was looking for. No. Not what I was looking for. Little bugger. Oh, I swear to God, they are there, people. They are there. I swear they are there. I'm not lying. That one I fought, there is no way that was a bowfin. There we go. Alright, let's see what we got. We just got us another bowfin, or do we have us an actual bass? We have us one genuine trophy largemouth bass, guys. Got it the 11th hour of the 11th day. A lot of frustration, but there he is. There he is. I swear, man, you have been elusive. I wish I could have seen your buddy that was giving me such a fit the other day, I tell you. Lord, I've never seen anything like it. Alright, guys, yes, they do exist. They're just very hard to catch. I am keeping that sucker, and we are done. Anyway, guys, please be sure to share, comment, like, and subscribe. And if you know of any other additional spots for these guys, please, please, please let me know. Anyway, I will see you later. Bye-bye.